Welcome again to Nick and Daniel's Pallet Wood Camper Build. In their last video they showed how the interior walls of the camper with cardboard and fiberglass. This video is about how they installed 6 5 watt 12 volt direct current LED downlights to the underside of the sliding bunk. They are also made from pallet wood. These downlights were simply inserted into the precut holes, two rows of three lights of which they will be wired, two rows of three in a parallel setup finally being wired to the control rocker switch unit they also previously made. The sliding bunk was quick and easy to build and make, also from pallet wood. The lifting up of the bunk operates via a paracord and pulley system to allow the raising of it and lowering of it within guides at either end of the bunk. The wiring will easily go underneath the bed and appear from end to end, allowing the cable to be secured towards the ceiling of the camper trailer, along the ceiling of the camper, and will be finally wired to the control rocker switch unit that they've already built. As you can see, Nick is keeping the cables tidy, securing them with cable ties and utilizing terminal blocks to connect the wiring at different stages of this parallel wiring setup. Wiring DC power sources in parallel involves connecting the positive terminals of the power sources together and the negative terminals together. This configuration allows the voltage to remain the same while the total current capacity increases. Here's a step-by-step guide. Identify the power sources. Ensure that you are working with DC power sources of the same voltage rating. Connecting different voltage sources in parallel can lead to undesirable outcomes. Gather materials. You'll need wires, wire connectors, and possibly a soldering iron and solder. Disconnect power. Before making any connections, ensure that all power sources are turned off or disconnected to prevent any electrical accidents. Connect positive terminals. Connect the positive, plus, terminal of one power source to the positive terminal of the other power source. You can use a wire and a wire connector for this purpose. Connect negative terminals. Similarly, connect the negative terminal of one power source to the negative terminal of the other power source using a separate wire and connector. Secure connections. Ensure that the connections are secure and that there is good contact. You may use soldering for a more permanent and reliable connection. Insulate connections. Once the connections are secure, insulate them using electrical tape or heat shrink tubing to prevent short circuits. Test the configuration. After the wiring is complete, you can turn on the power sources and check the voltage across them. Ensure that the voltage remains the same as that of an individual power source. It's essential to note that while connecting power sources in parallel increases the total current capacity, the voltage remains the same. Also, be cautious not to exceed the current rating of the individual power sources, and make sure the sources are compatible for parallel operation. Always follow safety precautions and guidelines when working with electrical components. In our next forthcoming video, we will show you how we secured the sliding bunk with ladders made from pallet wood and some sliding bolts. We will also be staining the interior and placing the furniture we made from pallet wood temporarily, as we have to leave the project for a couple of months. We do, however, meantime have more videos to upload to show further progress. Please subscribe and support our project. Thank you for watching.